Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, brothers and sisters. Today, let's talk about my engagement is messed up. So what we want to do, inshaAllah ta'ala, is we want to pay attention to some of the signs that an engagement is not going very well. And this is really important to know. Because what often happens is that both sides within that engagement get caught up in their feelings, they get caught up in distractions, the wedding, all the different plans, and actually lose sight of what's really important, and that is your relationship with that individual. Some of the things that might indicate to you that this person may not be the most suitable individual for you. So we want to talk about what some of those signs are, inshaAllah ta'ala. So here's number one. The value that you put in a relationship is going to determine the value of the outcome of that relationship. So in other words, if one side or both sides are really lazy, they're very lackadaisical about their plans and their future, what they want to do, what they want to accomplish, they just seem like they don't have that much interest in the relationship itself. You or one side or both sides, either one person is depending on the other to make all the phone calls, to write all the emails. One side always has to initiate a conversation. Whenever there's a problem, it always seems like the same person has to resolve those issues. Now keep in mind that when you are speaking within an engagement, there obviously rules that you have to follow. So there's a certain level of conversation that you're permitted to have, which of course should not have any desire or any fitness. So once all of these things are eliminated, you need to pay attention to the level of interest the other person has within that relationship. And this is all coming back from one very important hadith that our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam once told us as a general rule when we're dealing with one another. He says, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. None of you have really completed your faith, meaning you haven't reached the perfection of Iman unless you love for your brother what you love for yourself. So if you love for the other person that you want them to feel wanted, accepted, give them the attention, the rights that they deserve, then that's the same way that you want to also be treated. So you have to give that to others. You have to treat people the way you want to be treated. And don't expect that somehow when the marriage happens, all of this is just going to unfold and things are just going to be better. This is a really naive approach when it comes to an engagement. And it's really important that you keep this in mind, because what this is going to do is that this is going to build responsibility and maturity in that relationship. So when the marriage does actually happen, there isn't a lot of work that has to be done. You both know exactly what you want. You both have the responsibility factor in place, and you are both ready to take care of each other. No one is going to be dependent on one person to do all the work like how they were dependent on it during the engagement time. So that's really important. It sets the whole psychology or the mentality for both parties, so when they get married, inshaAllah ta'ala, they can treat each other as equally as possible. So that's the first sign, is to look out of the value or the effort one person is giving to that relationship, because based on that effort, there's a good possibility it's going to reflect the effort that they're going to put in the actual marriage itself. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.